Today we're going to combine the powers of Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator to create a contour map effect. You know, the ones with loads of lines that show the topography of the landscape. They're often associated with adventure and outdoors themed designs. I remember seeing them used as part of the branding and opening titles of one of Bear Grylls' Survivor TV series. We'll use Photoshop's filters to produce the basic contour map effect, then we'll bring it into Illustrator to vectorize it and customize the paths to add various line weights and styles. So begin by opening up Adobe Photoshop and create a new document at your desired size. Don't worry about the resolution too much because we'll be vectorizing the artwork later, which means it can be then scaled to any size without any loss of quality. Hit the D key on the keyboard to make sure the foreground and background colors are reset to their default black and white. Then go to Filter, Render and Clouds. Next go to Filter, Blur and Gaussian Blur. The amount you add here determines how smooth the lines are. 20 pixels is a good figure to run with. Go to Image Adjustments and Posterize. The figure you enter here will determine the density of the lines, so a higher figure will result in a more complex image. I'm going for 15. Convert these blobby shapes into lines by going to Filter, Stylize and Find Edges. Now we could end the tutorial here and make it a Photoshop specific guide, but you achieve the best results by using the strengths of the different applications. Select all with the Command and A shortcut, or Control and A for Windows, followed by Command or Control and C to copy. Open up Adobe Illustrator, create a new document and paste in the raster artwork. It's useful to go to View and Hide artboards to give yourself a nice full screen work area. Open the Image Trace panel from under the Window menu, then expand the Advanced options and configure the settings as follows. Change the threshold to 249 pixels. Now the max is 250, but for some reason the lines are invisible with this figure, so go with 249 instead. Reduce the paths, corners and noise to their minimum values to create smooth curves that accurately match the original Photoshop image. Then check the Strokes option instead of Fills. Turn off snap curves to lines, but turn on ignore white. Turn on the preview in the bottom left corner to check if the vectorized version accurately matches the original. Go to Object and Expand to permanently apply the image tracing, then right click and select Ungroup. Do this repeatedly until the Ungroup option is no longer available, which means all the individual strokes are completely separated. We can now use Illustrator's strengths to customize these lines. They're all individual vector paths, which means you can change the stroke weight, colour and style however you wish. Draw a selection around all the lines and reduce the stroke weight to 1 point. Click anywhere to deselect, then select just one path. Increase the weight of this stroke to 3 point. Select a few more random paths across the pattern and increase the weights to 3 points to match. We can even get a bit creative with the stroke settings. Select a stroke and increase its weight to 2 points, then check the dashed line option in the stroke panel. Change the settings to a 20 point dash followed by a 5 point gap, then a 7 point dash and another 5 point gap. This applies an alternating dashed line effect. Rather than type these settings every time, use the eyedropper tool to apply this stroke appearance to other paths. Hold the Command key to quickly toggle back to the selection tool in order to click another path. Select the rectangle tool and draw a shape that snaps to the top left and bottom right corners of the contour lines. Turn on Smart Guides under the View menu to make it easier to snap to these points. Clear out any stroke it might have, then add a nice colour as the fill. I'm using EDE1D1. Use the shortcut Command Shift and the left square bracket key, or right click and go to Arrange and Centre Back to place this rectangle underneath the lines to act as a background. Hold the Shift key while dragging a selection over all the elements, which will select all the lines while simultaneously deselecting the rectangle. Change the stroke color to something to complement the background. I'm using a bluey gray of 636872. As a finishing touch, we can select all and copy all the elements back over to Photoshop to add a folded paper texture to give it the authentic vintage map look. Change the blending mode to Multiply to allow the texture of the paper to show through onto the clean artwork. So I hope this contour map effect comes in handy if you ever want to create any adventure or outdoors themed designs. If all this sounds like too much hard work, I actually have a collection of free seamless topographic map texture patterns available on my website at spoon.graphics that you're welcome to download. As always, thank you very much for watching and stay tuned to the Spoon Graphics YouTube channel for plenty more video tutorials for Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator.